Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. She used to be an actress.
Did she ever do anything I saw?
I think her biggest deal was she starred in a pilot.
What's a pilot?
Well, you know the shows on TV?
I don't watch TV.
Yes, but you are aware there is an invention called television, and on that invention, they show shows?
Yeah.
Well, the way they pick the shows on TV is they make one show, and that show is called a pilot. And they show that one show on the two people who pick the shows, and on the strength of that one show, they decide if they want to make other shows. Some get accepted and become TV programs, and some don't become nothing. She starred in the ones that became nothing. Not great. Got beef, got steak ho, got cheese, got a great A-ho, not lean, got me A1, sauce please.
Welcome to Couch Pilots, all of my friends. We're still the show that dares to fly into the unknown territory of awful television pilots of the past. My name is Jason, and with me is my hamburger boy. It's Captain Philip Restisher. I love you.
I'm ground beef, baby. Love you, too. Love that cow song at the beginning.
I wrote that.
Did you? Mm-hmm. Well, at the beginning, I thought it was just like saying, mom. She was saying, moo.
Have you heard Doja Cat? Have you heard that before?
Not until you played it for me a couple days ago.
A little sneaky peek at the moose, which we have some news about. but yes, I came across that song because it's just called Moo, you know? And today's show is called Cows.
Yeah. So it works.
I thought it fit.
It works for me.
It was a viral sensation, I think, a couple years ago. I never heard of it. I'm old. I'm a chuggy. That's what they call me.
What's a chuggy?
It's what Generation Z calls millennials to make fun of them if they're trying to like
be cool and
still
hip.
Be with it. Yeah.
Okay. They call them chewies?
Chuggy.
Chuggy. What's that mean, though?
It sounds to me like a British candy bar.
Right. I was like, I've been eating chuggies all my life. You know?
So it's almost completely nougat.
There's been a couple girls in my life. They've been chuggies, if you know what I mean.
High five it. Pretty good joke.
Thanks. Starting off hot, probably going to go downhill from here.
I was listening to the episode that came out today because I'm a narcissist and I listen to our own show. And I got to say, it was one of those episodes that Blake was just on fire.
Really?
And you are Blake.
I listened to it for about 10 minutes and was so annoyed by myself that I turned it
off. Oh, really? That's great, though, because you never listened to the show at all, so 10 minutes.
Well, because I knew Matt was on. I was like, oh, I should check it out. And I did, and I was just like...
He's a good boy.
I was like, God, I suck more and more at this after 32 years. You'd think I'd be pretty good at it. But I'm glad to see you. It has been a while.
Yeah, I used to record another show over here, so I would see you every week.
Right.
Because I would do it in the off weeks, but that show is not going right now, so I'm only seeing you like once every other week, and I said...
It's probably going to help our relationship in the long run, wouldn't you say? Not having to deal with me as much?
But I barely had to deal with you when I was recording the other show. It was just nice to see you in passing and ask you to jump on that show, and you say no to me. That was an exchange that I was becoming comfortable with.
And then tonight you said, you want to come down and join me on the show? And I said, no.
But this is the show you're a co-host.
Yeah,
for.
And you reminded me of that. I was like, ah, shit.
Yeah.
Right. But I said no. But then you said, wait. Mm-hmm. I've got a guest that you don't want to miss.
I said, I know you don't like me, but you like...
No, it's not that I don't like you.
You might like me guest.
You always say I don't like you.
Right.
That's not it.
You said I had a heart of stone before we started recording.
When it comes to animals.
I'm good to animals.
No, you're very good to them. You just tolerate absolutely nothing. Like, if you meet an animal, you're like, oh, this is a wonderful animal. Mm-hmm. And then about 30 seconds into it, if they don't like do exactly what we want, you're like, fuck you, I hope you die.
Well... About the die part, but I do say fuck you to a lot. Yeah. Let's get our guests in here. I'm gonna play the music.
This is you, buddy. This is all you.
All right. Pretty frequent guest.
Yeah.
A guest with legacy on the show. I think one word comes to people's mind when we announce who this person is, and it is my sister. But that's not the word that comes to mind. It's the word is chicken. This is my sister Sarah. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
When you told me that Sarah was going to be on the show, and I'm like, Farmer Sarah on the show, can't wait.
That's my official name.
Farmer Sarah. Does your husband call you that too? He's like, oh, hey, Farmer Sarah.
He does.
Yeah.
That's funny you mentioned her husband. Two things I wanted to mention about it. First of all, what does he think about you coming over to do this? Does he hate it?
He hates it a little bit.
Why?
Yeah.
Why is that?
I don't know. He's just funny about things.
Does he think you get too personal? Does he think that like millions of people listen to this and they're going to come to your house?
I feel like he's got this weird jealous side.
Of what?
And there's nothing to be jealous of. You hanging
out with your brother?
Yeah, I don't know.
What if you and I just went out to dinner sometime? Would be like, I hate that. Would that, is that what
he
would
probably would be like, you and just your brother? Like he would always have this kind of weird questioning.
Okay, so he does. I have a rich history of female partners hating me do this. And since you've been married to Bob so long, and I truly do love Bob, I'm just going to end it right there. I'm not going to say anything more. But the other thing I was going to ask, though, about Bob is a different subject, is I did a cameo for him for his 40th birthday.
Yeah.
Cameo is an app you can Blake hates the cameo app after his experience. But we've used the cameo app for a couple of the videos we've done online. We've had Ron Harper from the Chicago Bulls fame. We've had Mick Foley, WWF Hall of Famer. And another WWF Hall of Famer I got from my sister's husband, Bret the Hitman Hart.
Yeah.
What did you think about that? Did he like
it? It was amazing.
That?
Oh, yeah. He loved it. He absolutely loved it. He showed his friends.
Did he really?
Some guy at work. Oh, yeah. He thought it was pretty awesome.
I wrote the whole thing.
Yeah. And the guy was sincere reading it, too. Like, I think he even had some of his own words, maybe. But, yeah. It was really nice.
I think the video, and you can correct me, because you did it probably more recently. Well, about the same time you and I did. It was about, it has to be like 90 seconds, right?
Yeah. You only have like so many characters. It's like half of what Twitter is.
It's like you get a 90-second video to send to them to kind of like beef them up on what the video should be or give them like the tone of it. And then, X amount of characters. But I wrote all that.
Oh.
And I tried to make it.
Sweet and kind.
I was trying to make it that way. And I think the words were good. But from the Bret Hart. That's right. But I think it was made even better by the fact that you're right. Bret the Hitman Hart really did an excellent job. Like, he's not known for his mic skills.
No, but you could tell that, like, he cared that somebody was giving him money to do something, unlike Ron Harper.
Unlike Ron Harper.
You know who I learned was, like, the most top, like...
I think I know this, but go ahead.
The guy that is in The Office, the guy Kevin Malone.
Brian Baumgartner made, I think more than $1 million in 2020 just on Cameo.
Yeah. Wow.
It's insane.
It's insane.
It's smart, though, right?
Yeah.
Celebrity, because people think, oh, Brian Baumgartner is probably worth $1 trillion. He probably didn't get paid a ton as a background guy.
Sure.
Shows get expensive after a while. The main people want a lot of money. Brian, you want to bitch about how much you're paying? Brian, we'll bite you off the show.
Right.
He hung around for a while, but he's making it work for him now.
Yeah.
Smart.
Got to do it. Got to make that money. Got to do that side hustle. And Sarah's side hustle is being a farmer.
I am. Mm-hmm.
And not like...
Not really.
When somebody says, oh... she's a farmer. You think, oh, like corn or soybeans.
Right.
No, she's a livestock farmer. She has chickens.
You would have been able to vote in the past before suffrage.
I'm surprised that you don't get all that government like aid. Mm. You know, all the farmers get the government aid. I don't know why you are not like rolling in bank.
Why aren't I? Yeah.
It's because Bob's not filling out the paperwork.
He's too angry about her
he's
coming
too,
over.
He's too mad about you. You're like, hey, Bob, while I go do this podcast with my brother,
fill out my paperwork. He actually did. I said, hey, put on the headlamp and go give them some water because they're probably out.
Put on the headlamp.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Great show title if we had show titles.
That was that Wallflower song, right? One headlamp?
Yeah.
That was a good headlight. One. Oh, headlight. Damn it. Whoops.
I thought that song was about chickens.
Well, how many chickens? At your height, you had 9 chickens.
I think, it was at my, you're right. And I have 9 right now.
But you've had turnover in terms of.
Yeah.
We were talking about how, like, Blake's got 2 huge dogs, and one of them's an asshole. And it barks at me. And even though I bring it treats, I specifically come here with treats to give these dogs.
Mm-hmm. And they do appreciate it. They do.
They do. And then you have a couple of dogs. Are they Labradoodles or Golden Doodles?
They're Golden Doodles.
Okay. And they're they've calmed down a little bit, but they're kind of sons of bitches.
Yeah, one of them especially, yeah.
And they ate some of your chickens, right?
They killed 2 of my chickens. Yeah. I was not happy with them for a while, but it's instinct. It's not like, but...
They didn't do it because, hey, that chicken's an asshole. It's just, hey, I'm
a dog.
I am dogged. My DNA says to, there's an animal that I could eat.
Yeah.
Whether fried, baked, or raw, I can just eat this...
Scorpion and the frog situation.
Sure. Yeah.
Blake, what's something that you do where it's just like instinct? And maybe it would be looked down upon by others, or maybe it's not morally right, but as a human being, as Blake Clayton, you can't help but to do this.
And I know I'm a girl here, but you can just be yourself.
No, he's never, he would not censor himself for you. Okay.
I sit down when I pee at home.
Nothing that weird about
at
you,
work.
Right?
Are you a lot of people think that's weird.
Are like, you making brown?
Brown cow? No.
Hold on a second.
Just yellow cow. I sit down to pee at home.
Yeah.
Unless I'm really drunk and it's, or it's the middle of the night. And like in the morning, I stand up because it's a relieving feeling. But most of the time at work and stuff, I sit down to pee.
And why is that though exactly? Do you not know, or is it just one of those Blake instinctual things?
I think it's just easier to hold your phone and flip through TikTok if you're sitting down.
That's true. That's true. I have, some people, you go to their house and they have the toilet seat up all the time. Not in my house. Toilet seat always down. That is an open bucket of water. Anything could go in there. Phones most likely.
Sure.
Do always closed.
We do it because we have two humongous dogs that think any water that's not moving is something that they need to drink. So.
Yeah. Sarah, do you have anything like that? Something instinctual you do?
Mostly as a mother, like when you step on the brakes, do you put your arm out to whoever's in the passenger seat? Nope. Yeah. Just fuck them. Let them go through the window, right?
Yeah. They don't have their seatbelt on there.
Yep.
That's on
them. That's them fault. You try to teach them. You've told them over and over. And at some point, they have to learn the hard way.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
I don't know what my instinctual stuff is. I know like bad habits. Just like go right to like mad mom sometimes for no reason.
Right.
Just start yelling. Be like, your shoes off the floor, you know.
I have a thing. I'll give you two examples. First one is if I get scared for something that my daughter Lorelai has done, I'm scared for a split second, and then I get real angry. Like there's this one time she sat on the edge of this like railing at the movie theater. And you know, like when you walk out of the theater, sometimes there's that big hallway and there's a thing on top, and she sat on that. And I remember I grabbed her by the shirt, I picked her up and I put her against the wall, and I said, "Don't you ever," like I got angry so quick because I thought my daughter was
scared.
Be,
yeah.
So that I go from scared to angry very fast.
Me too.
And you son of a bitch. Something else that I do that's not as that's a little bit more lighter than that is you said you sit down when you pee. I pee almost exclusively in my bathtub.
Almost exclusively. God, why?
But then I always wash it down, though, right afterwards. Because I feel like I'm wasting a lot of water.
You put it in the tub, then you drink it? You said you wash it down.
Not wash it down my mouth.
Oh.
I don't put it in the tub. I don't piss in my tub, clog the tub, use a ciphering system to get it back to my mouth, and then wash it down. No, I piss down the drain, and then I wash it with a cup of, like, a solo cup that I keep in there. I don't want to piss in the toilet. I feel like I'm wasting a lot of water.
So when you're showering, do you just try to make sure you?
I
pee
only
at the
shit
same
in
time?
The shower. No, I don't line them up with me using the. I pee a lot. Some would argue that I pee more than I drink, which is an issue.
Do you drink a lot of water?
No, it's my water consumption's gone down.
You don't mind that?
That's zero. Probably.
Negative. No, at Red Lobster, I took 3 sips of a water because I was waiting for my margarita. So I'm up like 300%.
How much water is in a Miller Lite? I'd argue a lot.
Probably, yeah.
We were talking about chickens.
Chickens.
And
chickens.
Sarah's known as the chicken lady on the show. People will reference her sometimes, call her that. But Sarah, I don't know if this is you wanting to fight back or starting your own segment on the show, but you came heavy this time. With chicken facts. should we give her a set?
Give her some chicken music.
Okay, hold on.
Welcome to Matt.
No, that's no good. Here, let's do this one.
You're getting really good at that.
All right, Sarah, give us the facts.
Chickens! All right. So, it's more of like my top 10 favorite. I don't know if we'll go over all 10. It might be getting a little bit annoying. One of the facts, despite the name, they are not affected by chicken pox, which is generally restricted to humans.
Older chickens, we get shingles.
Older chickens.
Shingles of the
We'll often get shingles.
Talons. Nine. Let's see here.
Do the chickens have large talons?
They do.
Mm-hmm. So are you going from like your favorite?
Sorry,
or you're going,
that
you're,
was 10. Now
okay,
we're going
so
9.
Okay, that's great. I'm glad you started off with that one. I was like, I hope she didn't. That was not her number.
The
one.
Last one's going to be phenomenal.
Oh, yeah. It's like,
blow you out of your socks. Because
chickens can speak English.
That's really weird that you just said that. Okay. Number 9, chickens can taste saltiness but not sweetness. Mm-hmm. I would really like to know how they found that fact.
What about what's the fifth one? The recently added flavor, umami? Can they taste umami?
I didn't read about that.
Sometimes when Sarah has an instinctual reaction where she becomes a bad umami. Did you know that? Or an angry umami. Quick. Go ahead.
Okay, number 8. There is an invention, I like this one, called the chicken gun, which is used to test the resistance of airplane windows and engines by blasting dead chickens at the aircrafts.
Like Sully Chesley, right?
Sully Sullenberger?
Yeah. Miracle on the Hudson.
Well, and it's funny you mention that because when we first started the show, when we bought Air Force One, we had to have a safety test done, and they brought like 47 chickens, and we're like, what are all these chickens for? It's because we have so, you know, like the big window in the front, they did like 5, but all the ones on the sides, they just did 1 chicken. So I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
And then they did that chicken test with Fabio, right, when he was on that roller coaster? They fired that chicken at his nose? You've heard of that, right?
What was that? Wasn't that a real thing about a bird?
Yeah.
Fabio was on a roller coaster, and they're like making a thing about it. They're like, you know, oh, this is great. He's here to do this thing. And then like he was going so fast. I think he hit a duck.
And broke his nose.
Oh, yeah, broke the nose. And I think the bird like exploded on impact.
Kind of like Randy Johnson when Randy Johnson was pitching.
It's exactly like
and
that.
And he just completely obliviated a pitching. Oh.
Why would that bird do that? It was like a kamikaze situation.
Sure, right. It was obviously a Japanese.
That bird was hit, was a deep gambler's debt.
Right.
Okay, number 7. The record for most egg yolks in one egg is 9.
Whoa.
I've gotten doubles, but 9?
You've gotten double egg yolks?
Oh, yeah.
That's like a Nadia Solman situation, right? Yeah. The Octomom?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
If it's a chicken, do you think they'd call it a cocto mom, though? pretty funny. Pretty funny joke.
But that's 9, not octo.
Right.
It's 9-0. 9-0.
Thank you.
All right. Let's see here. Number 6.
So as a chicken parent and as a mother and as a provider for your family, like when you bust that chicken open, the egg open, and you see a double yolk, you're like, it's a no-bones day.
Oh,
or it's a bones day. Like, you're happy.
Yeah, I guess so.
Bones, I never heard that
it's
phrase.
It's a TikTok thing. Yeah. Don't worry about it.
Are you on TikTok, sir?
No, I'm not.
Okay, well then, now I know my audience, and I won't do any more TikTok.
Blake has started doing TikToks.
What's the word we need to use for him? The chuggy?
He's a chuggy.
I'm a chuggy. How do you spell that, by the way?
C-H...
E-W.
E-W.
G.
G.
I-E-Y.
Sure.
I-E or Y?
I-E-Y, correct. That's right.
Chuggy.
Yeah. Hashtag it on the show. We're going to get big numbers.
I was trying to. But
no, I don't know. I don't fucking know. It.
Okay.
This next one's a good one.
What number are we at?
6.
Okay.
When the chicken gets its head cut off, well, for one, guess how long it can run? What's the length?
How the distance?
Yeah, the distance.
245 miles.
I would say 3.5 minutes.
It's the length of a football field.
100 yards?
He's right then. 2.5 minutes. That's how long it takes a chicken to go that far.
Yeah.
He's right.
Got it.
Damn, good job.
He's really smart.
I did some...
quick chicken math?
Some internet today to try to, you know, fit in with your sister.
Thank
more.
You. Thank you for study doing some
chickens.
Internet today.
Thank you.
Yeah, I rarely ask you to do that.
Did you Google it?
He's been doing it more on his own. Just doing
that's what I. That's what I meant to say was Google, but I forgot the word, so I said internet it.
No one else uses any other search engine anyways.
Sometimes if I'm on Bing, I'll type in Google just to get to Google.
I quit asking Jeeves stuff. He just kept taking me to porn sites.
That motherfucker. Well, you got to stop putting in pornography. That's why.
Oh, my God.
Oh, hold on. I'm getting a phone call here. Hello, this is Jason.
Hi, Jason.
Yeah, who's this, please?
This is David Lytle.
David Lytle from my favorite episode, Rough Magic?
My God, yeah.
Hey,
how are you doing?
I'm gone. I'm recording the Couch Pilots program. What are you doing?
You are not.
You record every other Monday.
Are you guys doing that right now?
Yeah, Blake hates it.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Blake. Oh, glad to hear your voice. Love you, buddy.
I love you too, buddy. I miss you.
My sister is here, and she's...
Tell the kid to shut the hell up!
How are the chickens?
They're great. The chickens are great. They're cuddling closely. It's cold.
Wonderful. My wife dearly wants to get chickens, and I told her no, mostly based off of information I received from Couch Pilots yeah. and you yourself about the, you know, the shit and the terrible coop cleaning project that it is every week. And
it's not that
she
often.
She doesn't believe me, and I told her, I was like, I'd rather get a pig.
The last 6 years, my sister has had chicken shit caked under her fingernails.
I know. I met her.
Like usually, if you have something caked under your nails, it's like a millimeter or two, but it's all the way to the skin, all the way to the back. It's just all shit.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. What do we owe the honor here today to talk to you on the phone, David?
Oh, it's an honor to talk to you guys anytime. The classic pilots of Couch Pilots.
Thank you for saying that.
Hey, Air Force One, man.
Right.
Beautiful. You guys are amazing people, but I wanted to call in because I kind of had a suggestion for you guys.
We're always open to suggestions. Thank you.
Well, mostly for you, Jason.
Uh-huh.
Do you remember? Okay, so you remember me being on that episode, Rough Magic?
I said it before. Yeah, I love it. It's my favorite episode.
Yeah. So obviously you remember it. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, we were there, and of course
are you doing a 1,000 piece puzzle right now?
I'm actually cooking risotto.
Me too.
The main concept though was that came across in that episode, I think, was anal cancer, right?
Like dirty arsehole cancer. Blake was convinced that he had it. We were laughing at him. He didn't like that. And you were sitting back, kind of slack jawed, right, thinking every symptom.
Go ahead. We found out that we didn't have it, and mm-hmm. then sure enough, it was just the booze that was like treating us poorly.
Imagine that.
So along with that, I want to say, do you remember how we talked about how our wiping situation was?
Yes, I believe you said that you do a ghost wipe, which means that just by a human instinct. Yeah, can you hear us? I can hear you just fine. That's probably why he was talking over me earlier.
I cannot hear you.
Can you hear me now?
You can hear me. Can I call back?
Sure.
I feel like I should call back.
I'm going to hang up on David. I don't know. Not necessarily how I thought that would go.
This is David. Please leave a message.
All right. Well, we'll clean this up in editing. We won't do that at all.
No, sure. We'll just leave it in there. That's fun, right?
I didn't press anything. I didn't see there's a mute on or anything. I'd hate to ask for more chicken facts because here he is calling right here.
That's all right.
All right. We'll get back to the chicken facts. Hey, David, I could hear you the whole time there. I don't know what happened.
Okay, so what's the last thing I said?
Well, I'll tell you.
That you heard.
You were talking about wiping, and what I said was, from what I met Blake, he would take lightning-fast shits, and I don't know his wiping regimen other than I think he wiped very hard.
Abrasive.
Like, yeah, abrasive.
Okay.
He would use a half-ply and really tear into his anal flesh, where you said you would do a ghost wipe.
Not even a one-ply.
No, half-ply. Half-ply. And then you said that you would do a ghost wipe, which is you would take a shit and out of courtesy to yourself do a wipe, but end up with nothing on the toilet paper, so you'd add it back to the roll.
Indeed. That's exactly right.
Was that possible?
And so that was true at the time.
Oh, what's changed, David?
So during that time, my shits got a little sloppier. I must admit. And suddenly wiping, and I'll admit, I put on some weight too. Mm-hmm. So, you know, wiping just got a little more messy as it went. But however, this last few days, I have, because due to some being sick and some medicine that I was on, my shit turned into like little, like bunny plops.
Yeah,
little marble size.
Like little capers.
Bunny poops.
Like tasty little capers.
Well,
like chiclets.
It wasn't a caper. It wasn't like a pea. It was more like a marble.
Okay.
But nonetheless, you know, they were a little more condensed. And so I've literally taken like 5 shits today mm-hmm. and ghost wiped every single time.
Whoa. Impressive.
You don't know. the constipation that this medicine caused me also allowed me to ghost wipe like that, and I'll tell you, it wasn't bad.
Kind of a nostalgia shit, huh?
It was nostalgia. It really was.
Nostalgia shit.
Nostalgia.
Shit. Nostalgia shit is what I'm saying.
Nostalgia shit.
Okay, thank you. Jesus Christ.
Gotcha now.
Dave, I couldn't be more happier with that story. I really appreciate you sharing that with our legions of fans.
Yes. Now, I have one more thing.
Okay.
So, you know I own my own house now.
Congratulations.
I no longer rent. And we've discussed the not being able to use wet wipes.
Mm-hmm.
Like adult wet wipes.
Yeah, I have an answer for that if you need it, but go ahead.
No. You gave me your answer before.
Okay.
Ziploc.
I think I have one better for you.
Okay. Oh, you got it. Okay.
Because now that I own my own house,
yeah.
I of course don't want to be putting those wet wipes down there, because I'm fitting the bill now.
Yeah. So you can't call the landlord and say, "Hey, I clogged up my toilet with wet wipes."
Yep. And I fucked up this ancient freaking, piping.
In my resolution in the past, because I came across the same thing, and yes, I'm a homeowner, I had to flip the bill, was I will poop, I will wipe, and then I put the wet wipe, and I'll put it in a Ziploc bag, I will seal the bag,
in a Ziploc bag,
and I will put it in the garbage can.
I still can't believe you guys don't have the opaque bags yet.
We need to get an opaque bag. People can see my business today. So, okay, so what's your answer then, David?
Okay, here's your answer. You go ahead and get the softer ones that are actually for children, like baby wipes.
Mm-hmm.
And then when the girls come over and they see a freaking bucket full of, shitty wipes.
Yeah, right.
You just tell them, I like to babysit. I do it for free.
Oh, so it's kind of do the same thing, change the product, but lie to people that see that and tell them I babysit.
Exactly. Well, okay. Especially for the girls whoever comes to your house, which is, I guess, no one. Mm-hmm. But aside from, very attractive women.
Right.
And so who are you hiding it from, aside from attractive women that you want to sleep with?
Well, my last girlfriend said that I had the anus of an infant, so having having those kind of wipes would make sense. I don't know why that's funny.
But trust me.
I trust you, Dave. I've always said that.
I still have one child in diapers who has to be wiped. Mm-hmm. Those things are far softer. And so you just use those. Just throw them in the can, man. And you're good to go.
I'm going to look into that.
When some lady comes over to your house, stays a night maybe, mm-hmm. If you're lucky enough, she's lucky enough. You just say, you're right. She's fucking up. That is absolutely true. You are a very attractive man.
Can't do it.
But you just tell her, hey, no, I, sometimes I just like to, I watch out for some kids. Hell, you can tell me your sister's kids. Hi. Hi, sister. Tosher.
He said hi to you.
Hi.
Yeah, nothing creepy at all about me watching kids. Hey, thanks a lot, David. Those are some great tips. And then the story about you taking huge shits. I appreciate that very much.
Well, I love you guys, and I knew you would appreciate that story.
We miss you, David, and anytime you're back in the area, please let us know. If early as possible, if you can. I'd love to get you back on the show. We do a special recording date if you're available.
I love you guys, and I appreciate you, and I will definitely let you know when I'm in the area. And if you're ever out here in North Carolina, you will have a place to be. So I will take care of you.
What a sweetheart.
Come out and see me.
Love you, buddy.
Love you guys.
Bye.
Love you, Blake.
Love you.
Bye, David.
Bye, guys.
So anyway, the facts about the chickens.
you remember when David called in and told us about his shits? He's a good guy. I like him.
He was here on
your show?
He's been on the show. He was on my favorite episode we ever did.
Yeah. It was probably one of the best episodes we ever did.
Next to all the ones that you were on.
Thank you. Which season is it on?
I don't know. It was one of the times. Maybe the first Tuckley 10, actually. That was a British show.
Yeah. You want to go number five?
I don't know.
We can skip to number one if you want.
We need to cleanse our palate. We can go through that.
All right, rattle them off quick.
Quickly. Number five, chickens have prehistoric roots.
Funny.
It's not as good. They have Tyrannosaurus rex.
Anytime we see a large bird, I say to my daughter, That's a dinosaur. That's a dinosaur. And I will begin to say that, and she will finish a sentence for me. She's so sick of my shit. She's like, yes, Dad, I know that's a dinosaur. All right.
Okay. She finishes her sentence.
Sandwiches.
Number four, chickens can see and dream in full color.
How do we know that?
How do we know? These are real facts, guys. These are real.
Sometimes you see a dog like going like paddling while he's sleeping, you're like, oh, he's having a dream. But how the fuck you know he's dreaming in color?
Yeah. Because, well, the dogs do that a lot.
They tap into their brain.
They took the green pill instead of the red pill.
That might be it.
If chickens listen to classical music, they can lay bigger and heavier eggs.
So why would not every farmer do that always?
Electricity. You got to run a thing out there.
What about rap music?
Oh, yeah, good question.
Make them smaller.
No, they just make you want money more.
Bigger yolks. I always hear that about black music. They have bigger yolks. Yeah. Have you heard that? Big, fat, girthy yolks. Veiny yolks.
Like you can slap them up against the wall, they just stick.
Yeah, too.
No. Okay, number two.
Those yolks get a lot of girls pregnant, that's what I heard.
Chickens can remember over 100 different faces of people or animals. I believe that one.
I believe that, too.
My chickens know when I come. They're not like that.
Way to go, Bob.
As soon as I approach, they're God. Like, woman with treats. Woman with treats.
You got to be careful with that.
I know. I don't know why like I said that word.
But you can't say the C-U-M one either. You have to say C-O-M-E. So that's kind of on you.
Yeah, I didn't say it right.
It's kind of on you.
I should have, rearranged these orders. Number one's not the best. But chickens have their own unique language with over 30 different sounds to use to communicate.
That's a great job. Well, I enjoyed them. Don't feel bad about those. That was fun. But do you think they can understand us?
No, they can't understand us. Like, they have their own language.
But if you say, like, hey, Betsy, good morning, do they don't go, wah, wah, and look at you?
No.
Betsy's alive?
She's dead. Dog killed her. They definitely make certain sounds.
Did I pick a name? Oh, damn. I just ruined the bit. Sorry.
No, there's no bit. It's just you, me, and Sarah. That's the bit.
That's all I got, guys.
One last thing, and it has nothing to do with you, mm-hmm. Sarah. So just shut your fucking mouth in this part, or you can chime in a bunch. The other day, I was talking to my daughter about something, and it was about Blake. We're talking about Blake, and she said, why don't you talk to Blake about what you're thinking about? I was like, all right. So I said a note to Blake. I said, hey Blake, are they doing chicken wing Mondays over at the Moose? He says, yeah. He's like, you want to do it? I said, yeah. So we made a plan to go to the Moose on Monday. And in my head, I was like, my God, this will be like the eighth time I've been to the Moose. I have to join the Moose. And I wasn't like, damn, I got to join. I was just like, I had to do it. I feel like I'm taking advantage. Sure. So we went to the Moose. We had some delicious chicken wings.
From the worst bartender in the world.
And I am now a Moose member. Can you believe that?
I don't know what that means, but yay.
It's a secret society, you know that, right? Like you have to.
That's where you work, don't you? Have like a
part-time job there? To be a member, you just willy nilly, people can't just walk into the Moose.
That's true.
What do you have to do?
I'll tell you. They probably don't want me saying this. And Blake, you are responsible. Cut this out if we have to. I'd only ever been to the main room, which is like a bar and a bunch of plastic tables. Plastic tables. Come on, come fucking step
plastic
up. Get some nice tables. Yeah, get some nicer tables. I've been around the corner to the bathroom. You have a few drinks. You got to take a piss. This time they said, you want to sign up for the Moose? Follow me. They took me in the office. I gave them my ID. They took my information. And this is what they did next. They have one of those big copy machines, that were like the real heavy ones. Mm-hmm. And they said, take down
your
pants. Yeah. Oh, and so I had, and I was not, this was not sexual for me at all. I wasn't aroused. They took my flaccid penis, they put it on the glass, and they smashed it down.
They sanitize it before?
There's a guy named Jeremiah. Not that I saw. Jeremiah sat on top of it. It hurt like hell. They made some copies, and they said, you're in.
It's like a mammogram of your penis.
It kind of is.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then except we got no good results.
I was going to say, a couple weeks later, they called you with your results.
Just some colored chicken nightmares.
Well, but I do appreciate that you and Kevin both are now under the regime.
Mm-hmm.
I worry that Kevin's is almost up, I think, maybe, because my birthday, he did it on my birthday, coming up. I do appreciate that.
Expire?
Yeah, you got to pay every year.
$50 a year.
Mm. And the penis pick.
And
what about women?
What's that?
What about women?
I didn't ask. I don't want to know. I don't want to know what that looks like. That might be a mammogram thing.
It's a labia thing.
The labia. Good. I think I have to have a separate machine for that.
Oh, yeah. There's a separate machine.
I didn't see that. I don't want
to
see
it. Yeah. Yeah. Well, they didn't show it to you because there's a regular office, and then across the hall is the women of the Moose office.
Fine.
Women of the Moose office, and that's where that machine is.
And
at.
Then they did make me buy a Women of the Moose calendar for 2020. Not great.
It's all black and white labias.
And 86 and over.
It's all 1080p labia. The ladies are all 65 to 81. Not great.
No.
But it will hang
Not
in my
bad.
House proudly.
Not yeah. bad.
I can't wait till the day you get your card. I'm very excited. I want you to take a picture of your card.
Can I
view in your card?
Okay, can I frown when I take the picture?
Sure.
Okay.
So what all do you get being a member?
I get to go in their building.
Do you get a wood table and chair?
No. I got to stay in the plastic.
But you get very inexpensive drinks. You're the money that you have paid is going to Moose Heart and Moose Haven and helping those unfortunate. So
you know who's a member there are Mike and Steph All.
Oh yeah, they
friends of the family,
and they volunteer a lot, and I love both of them. They're awesome.
And I think without saying his name, I think on the episode that came out today that was released today, I think you mentioned him without his name, and we can talk about that after the show. Oh.
I just found some old pictures.
Yeah.
And Mike is wearing very short shorts.
No, that's not who I was talking about.
It certainly applies.
Oh. Well, I know, but it wasn't. Okay. That's not who I was talking about.
Mike Gall was a friend with our parents way back in the early 80s, and he was he loved to wear jean shorts to where the pocket could hang out.
Yeah,
I saw that picture.
They were very short.
It's pretty hot.
I saw that picture.
Yeah, I was impressed with those
pretty,
legs.
Pretty awesome. Pretty hot.
Ladies and gentlemen, the captains have turned on the fasten seatbelt sign.
Oh, boy. Today we discuss the pilot episode of Cows from the year of our Lord 1997. That was a great year.
1997, yeah. I graduated in 94, so I would have been 18, 19, 20, I've been 21.
Well, were you 21 or 22? Because you were held back a year, right?
70, yeah.
Because I was 16. So.
Oh, so I was 22.
Yeah.
I was having a good time. Well, actually, no. I think at 22...
At 21, you love to say that it was announced to you that you will be a father.
Right. So at 22, I was in a horrible marriage.
Right.
But I had a beautiful son, and I was drinking. I was going to the Silver Dollar
in East Peoria.
Nope, the Silver Dollar in Peoria Heights.
Oh yeah, that's another
because they were open
bar
at 8 o'clock in the morning.
8 o'clock in the morning.
This is 97. I did not look at the date. Oh, this makes me sad.
Oh, what year did you thought this was from?
Oh, I don't even
know. The 80s?
Yes.
Early. The 80s.
I think Britain has a rich history of their shows looking like shit until the early aughts.
Yeah.
I think now they look decent, but even back then, even though we saw it on YouTube, and there's probably a quality decline seeing something like that on YouTube, all their shit did not look great.
Yeah.
But that's all right. 97, I was in high school. I was 16 years old. That means you're probably 14.
Yeah.
I think were we 14 and 16 when we went to Portland? Or was it 97?
Probably 96 or 97. I would think I was going into my freshman year.
And you and I are talking about taking our respective families back to Portland, oddly enough.
Yeah.
Isn't that wild?
Yeah, I'm excited about it.
You got a smirk on your face.
I'm a little nervous because I was talking to a friend recently, and I guess over there, you know, culture right now is a little bit more extreme than what it is here with COVID.
I think it's people just rallying against the government and being angry. But I think if you are not going places late at night and you are staying out of kind of harm's way, I think
you're
you'll be fine.
A mask.
Just like anywhere. Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
I guess. You don't have to wear a mask outside, do you?
I don't know. I'm a little nervous about that.
It'll be fine.
It'll be fine.
It'll be fine. We'll go down to Voodoo
Donuts.
Put my mask over
my face. Yeah.
Yeah. Get some donuts, go to the gorge, start a fire. You know how it is.
Yeah. Burn down a big, beautiful forest.
Yeah. But 1997, I think we should go back there in our minds. And to do so, we'll talk about some things that happened in 1997 so we can properly put ourselves in the mind frame of when this pilot was begifted to us. Isn't that right, Blake?
Yeah. So, Sarah, you remember from being on the show thousands of times is we're watching a television program from 1997. We're in 2021, only a few days left of it. But we can't judge this pilot based
on...
Huh?
That's right.
Yeah, you can't base on today.
It's just not fair.
Yeah, I mean, in 1997, we didn't have rap music. right? We didn't have rap music in 1997. Nope.
Maybe not in England.
Not in England. we did not know what a platypus was in 1997.
It's the one of the only mammals that lay an egg.
But we didn't know that in 1997.
We didn't know that then.
And we didn't have Band-Aids. I mean, if you cut yourself before 1997...
Death sentence.
Death sentence.
Gangrene.
Malaria. Syphilis. Infection. Yeah, staph infections.
You're going to lose a limb easy.
Yeah, so think about that. We can't judge on today. We have so many luxuries today.
Yeah, the platypus.
Yeah. The platypus.
Simple knowledge of the platypus is a luxury we often take for granted. Some things that did happen that year, I'll go over in just a second, but it should be noted that all these things I'm about to mention happened in the United Kingdom because, gosh darn it, this whole season is about United Kingdom failed pilots gifted to us from a super fan of the show, mega listener himself, Chris Tuckley. This is the Tuckley 10-3.
Bam! Tuckley 10-10-10-10-10. Tuckley 10 hitting the ground.
That's enough of that. January 15th, Diana, Princess of Wales, calls for an international ban on landmines. Do you guys remember this?
Yes, and then didn't she walk through like a area like that was that?
Oh,
yeah.
She's a ballsy broad. Remember when the AIDS came out when the government invented AIDS?
Yeah, she started kissing Elton John.
Well, not only that, but there's like a famous photo of her like hugging a guy with AIDS when it was like, yeah, we are not 100% sure.
He might have this. COVID. Don't hug him. Yeah. But it's the same thing. Like, you would, if you knew somebody that was currently with COVID, you wouldn't go up and hug them.
Yeah, that's probably the case. And I think we know a little bit about COVID now, but back then with AIDS, we didn't know how it was spread, and she was hugging dudes. She potentially would have been like a first lady. You know, she would have been like the princess, eventually the queen, perhaps. Sure. All those ladies, they always have a cause, right? Like Michelle Obama was like obesity, right?
Yeah, hers was she changed the...
food pyramid?
The food pyramid.
Yeah. I knew you were saying food pyramid because you put your hands together at a 45 degree
angle. And then Donald Trump's wife, what's her name?
Malaria.
Melania.
Yeah,
Melania.
It's the same disease from a mosquito.
Yeah, her stance that she was, it was fashion.
Right.
You know, and she...
High fashion.
She took some risky moves with some coat that said something on the back of it, like, fuck my husband or something like that.
Eat the rich,
Yeah.
Yeah, she was like, no ugly children left behind.
Yep.
Snort.
I think I did.
January 19th, Chris Evans, not the one you know, resigns from BBC Radio 1 after his request for a 4-day work week is refused. Since joining the station as a breakfast time DJ in 1995, Evans had boosted numbers by audience members 700,000. Breakfast time DJ is kind of a funny. That's kind of a British. What do you say? Like drive time or morning DJ?
Shock jock.
Yeah, shocking disc jockey.
Yeah.
What do you think about 4-day work week? You work 5 days a week, right?
I do. Yeah, I'd love to have 4-day work.
The pandemic,
right?
For the most part, I worked a 4-day week weekend. I think I was more productive.
You had Fridays off.
I would work 4 10s, and then I would be off on Friday.
Why did they go? Why did they change it back? You know?
Because the company's like, hey, we've got all our ducks in a row. Our attorneys say we're fine. That we can't get in trouble. Have a lawsuit in regards to COVID in any way, shape, or form.
Right.
Let's go back to doing what we do.
Yeah, and then are you working eights?
Yeah.
5/8?
4 9s and an 8.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I work 5 days a week too, but I don't know what you'd call what I do work, really. Yeah. January 17th, East 17 singer Brian Harvey is dismissed from the band after publicly commenting that the drug ecstasy is safe.
Ooh, bad choice. I don't remember that band. Do I would have known any of their hits?
No, I didn't recognize them until this. I think it was just a British band, you know, like a boy band kind of thing, probably.
Bye, bye, bye.
Yeah. What's the hardest drug you've ever done, Sarah?
Hey, probably like just painkillers given by the hospital.
Okay.
What about you?
Same. Like, I've never done an illegal drug in my life to this day. I'm looking forward to it, though. I think when I retire, I'm going to really get into some shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You more like, you think pills or you think like...
Powders.
Stuff up your nose.
Powders. Yeah. All my money's going to... All my Social Security checks are going to go right up my nose.
Okay. I think that's smart.
So is that it really then? Just like pain, like prescription drugs is the hardest.
Oh yeah, I've never done any of the drugs. Never had a desire.
No cocaine?
No. I barely smoked a joint. I'm very sad.
Barely smoked a joint?
Yeah. Like.
And it made you sad, or you're sad because you barely smoked?
It's just sad.
She wants to have done more.
Yeah. Now you can't do it until your kids are out of the house.
I don't know. That stuff just never seemed like exciting to me.
Well, now that it's legal, are you have any interest?
No. Unless I knew it could like really heal me. Like, what about if I have Bob? Cancer, maybe I'll try it.
What about Bob? Is he into it?
No.
Edibles? You go to Colorado, you eat yourself a nice
often
brownie?
I talk about how in the office we should have brownies and chewies, but
no one.
Brownies and chewies.
Well, when we have hard day at work, chewies, I'm always like, we need some chewies. A lot of people talk about shots. I just talk about getting stoned and how everything would be a lot better.
Yeah, you're probably right. If we're all high on drugs, my God, wouldn't the world be better?
Yeah, I think so.
A lot of shit would get done.
It'd be a lot less tense.
A lot of bridges would still stand. All right, I'm back in 1997. Sarah, why did we choose to watch Cows?
Oh, there's many reasons. There's just three. Yeah.
There's three typical ones, but there's a Phantom Fourth that we've kind of already talked about. Tell us what
Phantom
you know.
Phantom Fourth? Just like the... Okay, I know that it's because it was a pilot, so it, never got to be an actual show.
Good.
It's on YouTube. It's free. We can find it for free.
Awesome! She got both of them on the one.
Oh,
it was on the internet and it's free. So
that's technically a win.
That's technically a win. But can you get the bonus? Can you get the bonus?
We kind of mentioned it already.
Geez. Otherwise, one of your chickens dies tonight if you don't get the
Which
bonus.
Which one?
Betsy.
Okay. I know. All I can think about is our phone call with the poop earlier. I can't
that's all I'm thinking about, too. I'm thinking about David Lytle's delicious asshole. I can't stop thinking about it.
No, not delicious.
Hashtag scat,
same,
right?
Same it's as really Sarah. Confused. We're both thinking about his hot asshole, shitting out marbles.
No.
Dark, dense, pure, perfectly round marbles.
And those ghost wipes.
Conversation.
Those ghost wipes.
That's the word. Yeah, that was
Yeah, I feel like we should. I feel like he was having a conversation with himself we should not have been a part of. Hear me now. The last one is,
Tell me.
Is from the UK.
Oh, because of you're doing the 10.
All right.
Okay.
The Tuckley 10.
Tuckley 10 3. You could probably find the entire episode of Cows by subscribing to Couch Pilots on SoundCloud, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or your favorite podcast app of choice, and then simply click on one of our classically blue links in our show notes or go to YouTube, Sarah.
Flight attendants, prepare
to
take off.
Was I supposed to say something?
You did perfect.
And see, we know that these windows are safe because
the chicken gun.
Chickens have been shot at them.
Bob's not going to hit you when you get home, are you?
With the chicken gun? Or just hit me in
Actually,
general?
Don't say it out loud. Blink twice for yes, he hits you.
or just order it. Come up to the bar and order an angel shot.
Yeah.
No, he's just funny about things. I don't know what it is. But then he'll joke around before we leave about it.
About how your brother's a fucking loser?
No.
Well, you tell that.
He's always like, "What do you guys talk about?" I'm just like,
"Listen,
a lot of random
listen
stuff.
To it, yeah. Download
random
it.
Stuff." It's hard to explain.
Nothing is edited. You're welcome to hear it in its entirety.
He says that. He's like, "What do you talk about?" And you whip out fucking 10 chicken facts. He's like, "This is what I'm doing tonight. Don't worry, I'm not cheating on you."
Oh, Blake and Jason are nerds. I get it. No one's trying to fuck you over there.
No, it's not. I don't know what it is. He's a homebody. He wants me to be a homebody, which I am.
Well, I'm more of a guy who likes a summary of pilots. When a family of anthropomorphic cows is introduced to their son's new human girlfriend, the differences in their lifestyle become more apparent when their house is destroyed and they must find a new place to live. Black.
I'll give it a B+.
Okay. Do you want to? You work at a school, so you're familiar with the grading system that a school provides. Are you? do you want to grade that summary?
I'll give it a 1. We grade on 1, 2s, and 3s, and 1 is failing.
Well, your school fucking sucks then. It's A, B, C, D, and F. Those
okay,
are
all right. If we do it that way.
No, I
they
want
had
yours.
They had to change the grading scale because they don't want to hurt kids' feelings.
Exactly.
I got a C.
You get a B+, though? Really? It was hard to watch for me.
No, we're just, that was just, the, no, 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 no.
Okay.
That was
the summary.
Just the summary that he read.
Summary.
I read a thing, and you graded just what I said.
Okay.
So you know what? Fuck it.
You're a pretty bad listener there, Sarah.
Interesting facts. Jesus Christ.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now give you interesting facts. These are facts about the pilot that you may not know. Jason has scoured the internet and bloodied his goddamn hands finding these facts. So shut your fucking pie hole, smoke a fag, and listen. You don't know what hard times are. Nobody's broke the rule in a long time, so I don't even bring up the rule anymore because nobody's broke the rule.
It's your prerogative.
I do what I want to do.
It's your prerogative.
Love Bobby Brown until he killed Whitney Houston by getting her addicted to cocaine.
Mm-hmm. So that was the drug Sarah said that she did. That was the hardest drug.
Right, yeah. She's like...
I love cocaine.
What are you going to tell your kids about? Would you tell your kids about drugs?
They know about drugs. Oh, yeah.
She's like, well, mommy's cutting a line.
What did you tell?
Tell her what I'm doing.
Mostly I tell them like sad stories to kind of scare them from doing it.
I don't do that.
No?
I don't do that.
Yeah.
This is what I tell my daughter. I think I've said on the show before. I said, no, like pills or powders or and needles and stuff like that. But I said, I understand if you want to experiment with stuff. I do. I tell because I feel like if I'm not saying what you're doing is wrong. I'm just saying if you like scare a kid or get them like nervous or angry about it, you're eventually going to drive them to it. Oh. And I want her to feel like she can talk to me about anything. And she's messed around with some stuff, not drugs, but she's going to a party and had some beers and stuff. She's told me about it. We have a very open dialogue about it.
That's great.
So.
You're not a Chewy.
I'm not a Chewy or a Betsy. But that's my approach to it, Sarah. We have kids about the same age.
Yeah, I get that approach. But
your kids are littler than his.
Not much. I mean, Nellie and Lorelai are...
Just under a year apart.
Oh.
Just under a year apart. Mm-hmm. I mean, I shouldn't say I just try to like scare them. But I just tell them real stories and how it can...
Real stories!
Yeah.
You put nine strangers in one apartment in New York City.
You sell drugs. You remember that from season one?
Yeah.
We all do. So she told me she's been to some parties and she tried like a seltzer and stuff. And I said, that's fine. And I threw it out there. Give me a call anytime. I'll give you a ride. No questions asked. I just want you to be safe. And I tell her the things how to stay safe. But I don't want to scare her from these. I don't want to stigmatize anything. I think if you start doing that, you're gonna fuck a kid up and they're going to like run towards the thing you tell them not to do.
Yeah, that's good.
That's my approach. We'll see how it works out.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
I only got one kid, so I can't fuck it up.
Listen to season 53 of Couch Pilots to find out where Lorelai has ended up.
She could be 6 feet under the ground, or she could be running a Fortune 500 company.
And our show will be a lot better because we'll have money behind us.
Interesting facts. Cows aired. I will say some of the first three facts here I want to present were all presented or given to me by Chris Tuckley himself. So.
Yeah.
Cows aired on Channel 4. At 10:25 p.m. on New Year's Day, 1997, fact. The cows' costumes took so long to get on that the actors had to get started about 6 in the morning. Drinks were taken through straws, and faces had to be cooled by attendants with fans. The head mics didn't work as well as expected, so all the voices were redubbed afterwards. Fact.
I thought so when I watched this. I was like, oh, they had to redub this.
I had read this before, or these facts, but I didn't remember them when I watched it, and I was listening for that, and I felt like, it was like, how are they doing it? I didn't feel like they were dubbed over, but apparently they weren't. Fact. In a 2009 interview, Eddie Izzard, one half of the show's writing team, briefly mentioned Cows, comparing the original concept with Planet of the Apes and remarking how the show's creators had realized partway through production that it would work better as animation. Fact, though.
Too late.
This is the last fact. This is the one I found. The show was apparently in development for a long time. The pilot was eventually shot in 1997, but already in 1995, Eddie Izzard was quoted as saying, "It's now about a group of cows moving into a street and how they get on with the people there who don't know many cows. It'll either be great or it'll be a pile of shit."
Cow shit.
His words. Not mine. Ooh, yeah. All right, end of interesting facts. Twitter responses.
Twitter responses. Twitter responses. I wonder if Jason got some Twitter responses.
I like that.
It's beautiful.
You and I harmonize real well
again. Yeah, we do. Let's do it again, right?
Okay.
Twitter.
Okay.
You want to do it with us?
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you, choir teacher. Okay, guys, we're going to start off on Twitter. Okay. On three. One, two, three. Twitter. Responses. Why is the dog barking upstairs?
That's a great question. I did get Twitter response. It was from one of the cows, too. One of the guys who's inside of a cow. Anytime...
Which one?
Oh, I'll tell you in a second. Know. Anytime we do one of these pilots, we take a look on IMDb and they say, who directed this? Who wrote it? Who's the creator, director, producer? Who starred in this thing? And we send them a message. And it says, hey, greetings from Couch Pilots Podcast. We talk about TV shows that had only one episode. Next up for us is cows. We're excited to watch and we're wondering if you had any fun or interesting info you'd want to share. Thanks. We hope to hear from you. Well, the person who did respond was James Fleet. He was Thor Johnson. He was
the dad.
He was the dad. That's exactly right. He was the dad in the cows program. Well, James Fleet, you can find him at James_Fleet on Twitter if you like. He says, the script was funny, don't you think? They should remake it as an art house animation film. It dealt with the complexities of speciesism. I said, man, I haven't seen it yet, but I'm really looking forward to it. It looks wild. Very interested in what Eddie Izzard came up with. In my research so far, it does seem that speciesism will be a factor. Wondering how it'll all play out. And then I went on to say, hey, how did you get involved with this project, James Fleet?
Ghost.
Radio. Ghost wiped. He ghost wiped me.
He ghost wiped you.
James Fleet totally ghost wiped me, but that's okay because I do appreciate one of the cows responding at all. That's always fun when an actor, an actor who has almost no skin in the game, you know, as far as like creating it or writing it, or it's not a child to them, as it were. It's nice when they respond. But I would say this, let's put 10 minutes on the clock. And we'll break down beat by beat.
No, not second beat by second. Beat. No, we're not.
Millisecond by millisecond. The pilot of cows. Blake, I wish to God that you'd start us off.
Oh, by the way, Happy New Year, everybody. I got my dates mixed up. It's January 3rd. Yes. So happy 2022.
I hope you all made it.
Why wouldn't they?
Well,
the internet might crash this year.
First of all, there's that. The internet might crash under its own weight.
And then alcohol consumption?
And then booze.
Ah.
Where did you hear that, Sarah?
Who told you that?
Nobody.
My chicken said he saw it in a colored green.
Betsy told me last night.
Do you have a chicken empath?
No.
All right.
Chicken seance. Right off the bat, again, this is actors and human beings with chicken. I know. Jeez, I got chicken on the brain. Cow.
Bovines.
He's got bow brain.
His new special is pretty good on
not bad.
Netflix.
He's pretty funny.
Yeah,
I'm a big Bovine fan.
Are you?
Yeah.
So all the cows are on the couch and there they're watching porn.
Human porn.
It does seem like it. And I'll say,
does it make a difference to you, Sarah?
It makes a difference to them.
Yeah, they're talking
because they refer to it as almost like a National Geographic kind of animal study show. I will say that the intro to the program is kind of like a real quick, it's black and white footage, and the cows are in, some of the cows are in the footage, but I don't think it's the cows.
Newspapers.
That but it's kind of like, at first I thought it was like a Civil War, not Civil War, but like a...
World War II?
No. What's
that? Protesting.
What am I thinking of? Civil what? Civil rights.
Civil rights, yeah.
That's what I'm thinking. But it was less like that and more like slavery. Is what it's more like, because if it's like, you know, all owned cows have been freed.
Yeah.
But at first I was thinking this is kind of like civil rights, letting these anthropomorphic cows given the option to like live their lives outside of farms. But it almost presented itself as like abolishing slavery, didn't it?
Yes.
I mean, okay. All right. Anyway, you're right. They're watching porn.
Human porn.
Anyway.
You're such a stickler. So then we have Rex who comes in, which he is the oldest son, is what I'm gathering.
Yeah.
Believe me, I had to do a lot of writing down and a chart and everything. But he comes in. He comes to, and he's having a date with a human girl named Pinky.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And he's taking her to the family house. The house, it looks like a house on the outside, but when we go in, it looks like a barn because they have renovated it to look like a barn.
Is this hay all over the floor?
Mm-hmm. There's no hey.
Thank you. Pinky's given a bowl to eat out of, like a dog, you think, or a cow. Perhaps.
I mean, just keep her in check, right?
Everyone's crowded on the couch and they start to asking about like shagging before marriage.
Right.
Like, I'm trying to understand where the cows. Like social etiquette comes in. Like, are they? How long have they been wearing clothes? How
yeah,
long
do they have cow brains, or do they have
yeah.
half and half brains?
Yeah, because cows are probably just out there like fucking in the fields, whatever they want to. Yeah, right?
People are tipping them over.
Yeah, but I don't know. Like, do they know enough about human life to like? Because we should be very clear. These are human beings wearing cow costumes, like mm-hmm. full on cow costumes, kind of akin to. One of my favorite programs of all time, that's Dog Police.
Oh.
Right?
Yeah. Oh.
It was the same thing, right?
Yeah.
It was guys dressed up like dogs from Dog Police. Do you ever hear this song before?
The song?
Yeah, the song.
I feel like you've played it before.
This is the first time I've ever played it on the show.
I'm pretty sure you've played it before.
Oh, that's right. Hold on a second.
Nobody knows who you are.
Bow, bow, bow. Yeah, it is really a yeah, lot like that, isn't it?
I thought the same thing.
Rex lights a huge cigarette and
can't. Yeah, it's not a cigarette. They talk about grass.
It's a big
Oh, is it a
It's a doobie because they okay. right before he has this big, huge joint, and when I say a big, huge joint, I think it's about 4 foot long.
Yeah.
But they're talking about they had bought some grass, and Pinky's like, Pinky, it's like, why did you buy grass? You got grass here. Like, oh, we got to get the good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a lot of doobies.
They're all, like, crowded on the couch, and... They don't need to they don't seem to know boundaries or tact, and the house appears to be like kind of falling down all around them, right?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of shit like from the ceilings like crumbling down.
Anyway. Like my life.
Jesus. Pinky sleeps over. The next morning, the cows are they mention that their hair is not real, that they're wearing wigs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
So it does make me think that these are normal cows that we are aware of. Somehow have broken their backs to stand upright and have decided to wear clothes and put wigs on.
Sure.
It's very bizarre.
To fit in because they're free now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you have that, you know, that walk of shame in the morning for Pinky. She comes mm-hmm. down and I don't think she has any pants on.
I think she's wearing a nightshirt.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, I like that nightshirt.
You guys didn't mention the thing about him using the restroom and the giant toilet paper roll, and then it's like really tiny when he comes back.
I don't know if I noticed it either.
And he said, "No, that was a thing." I thought that was so weird.
Catch that.
Holy way to go, David Lytle.
Nice.
Thank you.
Rex and Pinky, then again, Rex is a cow and Pinky's a human being. They announced their marriage, and I think they said it's going to be an Orthodox wedding, right?
Yeah. So yeah. Obviously, Rex is in effects right now.
Oh, I would definitely say so. All I want to do, you know.
Yeah. Zoom, zoom.
And boom, boom. Toby is called out for not knowing what sex is. He thinks that's their little pastries.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be nice, though?
Toby's like the younger son. Like the younger son of the...
He's two.
Yeah. He's two. Yeah, he keeps saying he's two.
What is that in cow years, though?
Two.
Okay.
It's him, and then like the older sister is Sheila, and then the oldest guy is Rex. And then you have...
Thor.
Thor and...
Buella. It's Buella.
I knew it as Boo, but the full name might be Buella. Buella. Yeah, okay.
You know, Buella DeVille.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. They then decide they need 10,000 pounds.
Yeah, because Rex has proposed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And he wants to marry a Pinky, and so they're trying to come up with money to have a great wedding.
Seems like they've been like bartering their way through life up to this point. They were trading potatoes for crisps, or is that what they call French fries? Crisps?
Or chips.
French fries. Yeah. Crisps are potato chips, I believe. Anyway, Shirley and Boo show Pinky their family album. And the camera, I know this is the first time I noticed, and it kind of goes throughout. The camera shots are sometimes
wiggly.
They're odd, a little wonky and jerky.
Sure.
And I'm not sure if this was done on purpose or if this is like something that happened when it was like transferred to YouTube. I don't know.
Yeah,
it's
I
very bizarre.
I didn't figure it out either.
Anyway, the cows pile into a cow pattern painted convertible, and they head out to find money for the wedding when Pinky slams their front door and their house completely collapses.
Yeah, the house. Yeah, she's like, they're like, oh, no, don't do, you know, don't slam it. And she slammed it. So they end up going, they're heading to Aunt Grace's house. Mm-hmm. And Aunt Grace is very rich, a very wealthy, a well-to-do cow.
It looked like one of those classic like English castle estates, didn't sure. it? Beautiful.
Yep.
I think Chris Tuckley lives on one of those.
I'm sure that he does. They bumble around the house with corny jokes, and they're breaking things. And they notice they do say that their house is a total loss because they don't have insurance. They're trying to get insurance.
They're trying to call and get insurance. Yeah. And there's some fart jokes, which again, I think every UK pilot that we watch has fart jokes.
Really?
Yeah. Cows are classic farters, too. There's the methane problem with cows, delicious buttholes. The estate that they're going to is run by a human man named Fetch, and he takes them to their aunt, right?
Yeah, and she's like, it's one of, you know, she's hoity-toity, you know, she's real rich, and then she's like, she asks them some questions, and they're like, oh, okay, you passed that. Now the second stage of, you have to chase me.
Yeah.
And they basically all just stand there, and she's in a walker, so...
She's moving real slow.
Yeah, so they just chase her, quote-unquote, real slow.
They chase her in her, like, her game room, where she's got, like, a whole gambling situation set up, and the final challenge is gambling, and they... They cheat to win, and the aunt, like, appreciates that.
No, they did. I don't think she cheated, though. They didn't cheat. She thought they cheated, so then she went along with it.
Well, no, then they put the money back on the thing. Like, they were both being... It was all dumb. Like, they were cheating to... Both were cheating to win. But anyway, the aunt writes her will and says, you know what, you can have whatever the will says a few months after I'm gone, but I'm going to allow you to stay with me. And then she says, I'm going to be struck by lightning tonight. And then she heads out into to a storm.
And she Ben Franklin's that shit.
She, like, purposefully goes out to be, like, to make her, it's a, what is that called?
She's an insane old lady. She has Alzheimer's.
Yeah, she probably does have that. Why did she do that, Sarah?
She's crazy. She's, move the story along. I don't know. She's just really, her voice is what kills me. And she's just very weird sounding and. She's always predicting the future, but, like, knowing it's going to happen, and she just, I don't know.
It's because she's rich enough to make it happen.
Yeah.
Right?
I guess. She's promptly killed outside, and they plan the funeral, and so we got to plan their wedding at the same time.
Right, yeah, because we have to, you know, why not save money and just have both the events at once?
Same time, yeah.
Well, Pinky's parents arrive to discuss the impending nuptials, and the Cows want to have a fun wedding with pigs and sucking cherries through straws, I think is what they said. And Pinky's parents want a serious, traditional wedding.
Yep. Right. Mm-hmm. And so they come to the conclusion that they're going to discuss. They're both going to share. Both sides are going to share what they want, and then they're just going to go from there.
This is a bizarre 50 minute comedy. Yeah. The comedy is we usually expect them to be about 22-30 minutes, and, like, all of these things are like, hey, this thing's going to happen, and the next scene we're seeing it happen. I feel like a lot of this stuff could be stretched out if they need it to, but it's like, hey, we're going to have a wedding.
Shove it all in.
And then 5 minutes later, the wedding's wrapping up.
Right, yeah, right.
Right, and, anyway. And the wedding wraps up by Rex and Pinky going into a tent.
Yeah.
And Pinky coming out screaming and running away, which has happened to me a couple terrified. Times
What did
in
he
my
do?
Life.
Do you remember?
Licked his nose?
Can either of you lick your nose?
No.
From my head to my toes to the toes.
Can you touch your nose with your tongue? I can touch the tip of my nose with my tongue, but I can't get in there and clean it out as much as I want to.
Can't do it.
Let's see here. Later, Shirley berates some of the estate workers, and Rex is getting drunk while reading poetry, and Toby shoots at some trees. Everyone.
Yeah, it's basically here's a lower class that are now have high class, high flutin'.
It's the Beverly Hillbillies with cows,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Nice.
They're all dressed well now, and they're kind of converting things over to the way of how they live, because it was a nice estate before, but now you notice there's a lot of hay all over the floor and everything.
And they're not smoking the grass. They're eating fancy food.
Oh, yeah. So fancy.
I'm so fancy.
Whatever happened to Iggy Azalea and her giant white ass?
She's got a new album out.
Oh.
I don't know.
I love it. I love it. I don't
she
care.
She seems to be
I love it.
Your sister's on the pulse of...
She's anti-Chugi. Yeah. She knows what's really going on the streets. Boo and Thor call in Fetch to dress him down for his behavior. And Shirley goes about getting angry at the staff, and the whole family convenes at a very long table for breakfast, where Thor says, I intend to run for parliament.
Yeah, I've been asked to run for a parliament.
Mm-hmm.
And so then he's like, I'm going to have the biggest dinner to announce it.
Yeah.
I'm going to have...
Present the bovines. Yeah. Yep.
Present the bovines.
He's got like important local politics guys over for dinner, and they're excited to get the cows involved in politics, because now they finally have a way to tap into bovine votes. And one of the few funny lines from the whole show was, you have one of the most valuable things to a politician, and then Thor asks, four stomachs?
Yeah.
That was good.
Maybe the only time I laughed.
And during this dinner, Toby gets mad at one of the humans that's there, and it challenges to step outside, which he has to end up doing, and we don't hear anything else about that.
He just the guy steps outside, and he just closes the door behind him.
Yeah.
Later, Thor is on the phone. He's invited to speak at the party conference. I don't know what party this is exactly.
Yes.
But cut two, he's being coached up on the way there. And then the family watches on a TV from outside. They've like set up a mock living room out on the lawn.
And I made a note, has closed caption, because I had accidentally pushed the closed caption button. And I thought it was just for this part. I didn't understand it. I was watching it at work underneath my desk. So,
as you often do.
Yeah. So.
Thor is now on a big stage speaking to a large audience. His speech is pretty nonsensical. He throws out the written speech that he has, and he starts to speak from the heart, and it seems to go over well until it does not.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And he blames things on sheep, I think. The sheep population, it is very much booed after that.
Anyway. So then after that, then they go to Aunt Grace's will reading, which it's 3 months later, so they've been living there. And it's a seance, basically.
Yeah.
She speaks through the lawyer.
Yeah. And knock, 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 Pinky comes in and interrupts and challenges the will.
Yeah, she's not here to make peace with Rex. She's still disgusted by what he did and doesn't want anything to do with it. But since they're married,
a girl would want a guy that can lick his own tongue, right?
Oh, yeah.
Because what does that mean?
Have you seen a cow dick, dude?
Yeah.
Huge. That's the noise they make.
It's more her parents. They want the house.
God bless them, everyone. Pinky says she's pregnant. What kind of abomination would that be, you think?
It was bestiality.
Yeah, well, that's just day one. That's base element. We know.
Well, they kind of find out they did it twice. I mean, she was only in that tent for like 30 seconds.
But what does that baby look like? Centaur?
Hoovy.
Yeah,
it's got a lot of hooves.
Hoof? a hooven child?
At the very beginning, he pulls out like an arm. Did you see that to turn off the TV? And like,
oh yeah, because they don't have the
They have not started making remotes.
Which
for cows,
that arm, I will tell you, I don't know if I want to say it's in front of you.
Oh Jesus!
But that arm is obviously like an anal fisting sex toy. Seriously, no.
But it was with
the pointer.
Yes, it was
really.
Yeah,
because I've seen.
I will show you if you.
You don't have to show me anything. But I've seen things at like adult sex stores where it's like a fist, but like a closed fist, kind of like that, to where it'd be you
skinnier.
Think,
yeah,
I've never seen one with like a pointer finger. That seems like you're tempting fate there.
No, that's to get to the prostate.
Oh, so it's for a fella. Okay, never mind. Blake knows exactly what he's talking about.
He's got one upstairs.
Pinky does end up getting the estate, but the cows get Pinky's old house. Mm-hmm. It's a house switch.
Yeah, and they go in and it looks really nice, like a nice little house. And they're like, it could be good with some remodeling. And they just turn it into a barn.
Totally fucking trash it again. That night.
I think they have issues with knowing like structural beams and stuff. I think that's why they keep caving in, is because they cut all the structural beams and support beams out of these houses.
They have no respect for load bearing walls.
Yeah, they like they like an open floor plan. Yeah. Nice.
High five,
Sarah. High five it.
The night they are outside on their front lawn burning materials from the renovation, and they're singing Home on the Range while upset neighbors emerge from their homes to look on as emergency vehicles are heard in the distance. Is that fair to say?
Yes.
Or maybe they're wanting to join. Ooh. That's a good song.
That is a good song.
Nice fire going.
Will you sing a bar of that for us?
Home on the Range.
Where the deer and the antelope pray.
Where seldom is heard
a discouraging word,
and
the skies are not cloudy all day.
Yeehaw!
Yeehaw! Sing, you bastards!
This is the part of the show where we say, "What the fuck was we just watched there? What was that?"
It was hard to watch.
What went wrong with cows? I don't know. Give me a piece of paper and a pen. I'll fill it up for you. Sarah, why didn't cows work for you?
Oh, God.
You got to make cows work for you. Yeah, get up on
it was
that
just
mic.
It was bad. It was just, I don't know. It was hard to look at those cows. Their jokes were bad.
Mm-hmm.
It was all bad.
Yeah, sometimes humor doesn't transfer across the pond. Blake, what would you do to improve cows?
I would say don't make it cows interacting with humans. Make it cows interacting with other animals. Like, just do a whole animals thing. Or a whole human being thing. Don't mix the two. It freaks me out.
Or even like just having them, you know, discovering the human world. But it had to go right to like
they're already knee-deep in
sex,
it.
Yeah, with a... It was just, yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, my problem was that I get to see the sex with Pinky. I wanted a whole 15.
You wanted to know how it worked?
My problem was I could hear porn, but I couldn't see it.
Yeah, that's how it...
That was so weird. That's how the start of it.
Blake broke Bing.
Oh, no.
Yeah, this is, like we said, you know, dramas, 45 minutes, comedies, half hour. This went on way too long.
Yeah, way too long. Yeah.
This is way too long. The jokes were dumb. If you're gonna have weed and you're going to have sex...
Smoke weed every day.
Crank it up a little bit. Let's make the humor a little bit more adult. We kind of teetered on just dumb jokes.
Right, it was like watching like the dinosaur. Remember the dinosaur show?
Hell yeah.
And
that
then,
show sucked.
And then, yeah, but then like, and Married with Children. It was like, if you mesh those two together, it just...
Man. I don't mind the human interaction with cows.
I bet you didn't.
Well, doesn't matter what I did in the privacy of my own home.
How'd you get a cow in that small house?
Listen, I only need one end of the cow in my front door. But yeah, I don't feel like they could have cranked up this. Like, I think they're making a social statement with some of this stuff, right?
Sure.
But it was like two. I don't know. There
wasn't a lot of conflict in between the two. Like they made it seem at the beginning like there was conflict. There was an uprising. You know. There was. You know.
Yeah.
And but you know
there wasn't a lot of prejudice.
There wasn't a lot of prejudice or disagreement.
But they were trying to make it like a social issue thing. And then, like I said, it was too long, and it wasn't funny.
No,
they mentioned at one point it would be good if it was a cartoon. Yeah, maybe it would.
Yeah,
but then you'd have to make it for kids. I think.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. There's just if you look at Eddie Izzard's writing history, all the things he's credited for writing wise on IMDb, everything on there is stand up, except cows, and I think that tells a pretty powerful
for
story.
Sure.
Is your phone ringing?
Yeah, it said Mindy Hash.
You got to answer these things. Put them on the show. Why not? Why not?
I don't know who Mindy Hash is.
Why not? Put it on the show.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's not a good answer. I really want to hold your feet to the fire on that kind of shit. All right. I'm not going to do it, though. We're not the only ones who've seen cows. Other people have seen it. No one scored it on Rotten Tomatoes, but I'll tell you right now, it's on IMDb. Blake, do you care to take a guess on what people from around the world scored cows?
I think they rated it a 3.5.
Sir, do you want to guess? This is out of 10 decimal points in play.
I agree. It's probably around that.
The 6.8.
What are you?
And that's not right. That's from 23 ratings. These are people who love Eddie Izzard. I don't know. Do you know Eddie Izzard?
No.
He's a guy. He's probably like 60 right now, maybe a little over that. And I think he was famous for being like a guy in the 90s. He's a man. He's like, I like dressing like a lady, like with makeup. He like wore ladies' clothes. Sure. And I was like, is there a shock value in that? Is there a reason? Like, who gives a fucking shit?
Back then there was, but not now.
Is it funny? Do you know his comedy, though?
No.
I sure as hell don't. Anyway, well, he's had some success here in the United States for sure. Anyway, critic reviews. Martin Schneider from DangerousMinds.net says, it's hard to make heads or tails of this 49-minute pilot. It doesn't hang together as a single story, and the episode breaks aren't clear. I agree. This is four episodes of a show.
Yeah.
Whatever. Viewer reviews. 8 out of 10 scars. A forgotten classic? Eddie Izzard is a strange fish at times. I'm sure he would think he'd be the first to admit it, but a sitcom about cows? Not as strange as you may think. The plot is simple enough. In the title sequence, the history of cows revealing their sentience, their struggling for equality is quickly dispatched. Though Izzard worked with them in the excellent Rex Hunt, he's talking about Catherine Zeta-Douglas, Catherine Zeta-Jones. He says cows is a strip on Izzard's site for while that doesn't seem to have gone as well. Yeah, whatever. Jim Breen says, watch Cows for a second time. It definitely gets better the more you watch it.
Oh, no.
Eddie Izzard is a top comedian. Chris Buchanan says, I've been hearing about this for years and years. Really nice to finally be able to see it. You can see Izzard's hand behind every line, can't you? If this is a testament to Eddie Izzard's comedy, I'm probably not very interested, right?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Jimmy Veal says, LOL, this is awesome. On the start, I thought he was he's listed random celebs' names in the suits because no one can see who they are, but it actually is them. I believe Pam Malarkin is in it. It's so awesome and funny. A lot of these are British things. I have no reference.
That's a lot of my problem.
I can't reference this stuff. Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to FCA Airport.
Blake, I love the red, white, and blue.
Hell yeah.
For your safety and comfort.
The things you do. America. America.
This is you. Doop, 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 doop. How many guns do you own, Blake? Because as an American, I own about 25 guns.
I own zero. My wife won't let me have one, which is another reason she's out here.
What's that?
Yep. Just Mike, one, two, check, check.
Now is the time to grade cows. It's appropriate. We've done everything else. We've done more than almost anyone in the world has done for this podcast, right?
Yes, for sure. Yeah.
We do it on a scale from 1 to 7. Blake, do you want to break that down for us?
Yeah, it's 1 through 7 based off of the 90s hit series Wings, which we love. 1 is the worst. That's Roy Biggins. And 7 is the best. That's Brian Hackett. Sarah, we have loved having you here. You're the guest here. Based off that rating, a one to a seven, how would you rate the UK pilot cows?
Well, I don't think it was the worst, but it wasn't good. Who's the second character, number two?
The number two on the scale from Wings in our grading system is Faye Cochran.
That's what I would grade it.
Yeah. A two? All right.
Feel free to elaborate if you want.
Just bad.
Just bad.
Hey, way to elaborate.
I'm going to go ahead, and I'm going to talk about this for a second if you want to let, or we got someone waiting for you upstairs.
Oh, is he?
Yeah. So, I think I've said a lot of it before, but this should have been a half hour. This is not very funny. I think if you're going to dress up like a cartoon wearing a cow costume, you better go hard as an adult, or you better go real soft for kids. There's no room for in between. No one wants to see milquetoast, half-baked, shitty jokes wearing a cow costume. I have to give this points for originality. I will be clear. I do not like this. This is not good. But I have to give it points for originality. I can't go a one. Sarah, I think I have to agree with you. This is a two.
Yeah.
It was not funny. It did not get picked up, obviously, for a series, nor should it have. I don't know. Maybe it would have benefited from Eddie Izzard being involved. Like I said, this is a guy who's, I think, probably in his 60s and has been a staple in British comedy for probably the past 30, 40 years. And if for some reason someone said, why don't you write a pilot? And this is what he did. Not good.
No.
Maybe
stick to the comedy.
He was on, I think he was on an FX show. Like, it was a drama.
Okay.
And I think it had some success. I think it ran for a couple of years. That's fine. Great. But he's, when you're going to write Eddie Izzard, make sure you do it in comedy, because this will not stand. I give it a 2. Captain Philip, rest assured, I turn towards you. How do you rate cows?
I all the season, I have decided to give every one of these pilots a British bump, because maybe I'm missing a lot of stuff because I don't understand British comedy. But I struggled so. I mean, I was working, I was watching this, and I was like, oh, I'm risking getting in trouble at work with my boss.
Yeah, mm-hmm. You did risk a lot.
To watch this piece of shit.
Right.
With the UK bump, I also give it a 2. I didn't.
It was going to be a 1, huh?
Yeah.
It was going to be the bottom barrel bullshit.
Yeah.
Wow.
So, 2's across the board.
Well, I think Bob should be jealous because we are all in the hand-holding club. The 2's all around. And with that, we close the book on cows, and we shall never, ever mention that show again. Join us next time, won't you please, when we watch the pilot episode of Biffovision. Here's a little something to wet your whistle. Biffovision was a comedy pilot that evoked the genial, low-budget DIY spirit of a bygone era of Saturday morning telly with a grown-up take on kids' TV. You can find the entire episode of Biffovision by subscribing to Couch Pilots on SoundCloud, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or your favorite podcast app of choice, and then simply click on one of our classically blue links in our show notes. Or go to Vimeo and get your affairs in order.
Gets me every time.
Wasn't Vimeo the alt-right?
No, that was Adult Swim.
Oh, yeah. Okay, my bad.
If you were to, if the only place was to watch one of our failed pilots was AdultSwim.com, then you would be forced to join the alt-right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But now it's Vimeo, get your affairs in order?
Right.
Okay. That's great.
Do you have your affairs in order?
Yes, I do. Oh, yes, I do.
We talked recently about me writing your will and
not my will.
Your last will and testament.
No, not the will. You write the thing that you talk about when somebody dies at a funeral, the opaque.
No, but we talked about your will, too, and how you're going to leave your kids, your
Oh, that's
Hank
right.
Hank Williams Jr. or your Hank Williams
senior
stuff.
Senior stuff.
And how if it's not in writing, it doesn't matter. Someone's going to get it, okay, that you don't
you're
want
right,
to
you're
get
right. You're right. I was fighting you on something we did talk about.
But we did talk about your eulogy, too.
Yeah,
eulogy.
Yeah.
Blake's death, there has to be a certain amount of peace in that. We have it almost completely figured out at this
yeah,
point.
Yeah, no, and I am...
We know step by step what it's going to take to get you in
the ground.
The only
thing that I'm not doing is standing outside during a thunderstorm with a giant metal pole.
You two can make that happen. I think we're going to have a tornado this week. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Going out there.
They said it's going to be like 70 degrees coming up. It's going to be a tornado, I tell you right now.
A little too close too soon.
Well, why? But Kentucky? I'm not making light of it. We're going to have a tornado this week. It's happening.
It's all right.
This is we're winding down here on the show. I will say while Blake gets some of his affairs in order very loudly that you can go to couchpilotspodcast.com. You can hear all of our episodes there. We've done close to 320 at this point. It's what we're dealing is silly.
Yes, it's very silly. but we love the people that listen. We love the people that come on the show, and that's the only reason we're doing this still.
Well, I enjoy seeing you.
They have nothing else to do.
Well, I have other things. I choose to be here with you, Blake.
Oh, you do?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Go to Facebook.
I come down here because you show up at my house. And
right.
I don't want to leave him down here by himself. That'd be weird. Plus, I got to carry the show, sir.
It's all craft room now down here. You moved all this stuff.
I know. It's at first, it was going to be like a man cave. And I got, I bought a projector and I bought a... bowling, like seats from a bowling alley.
Yeah, you fucked up.
And now it's just there's a bunch of televisions.
It's
like
it's the remnants of a man. It's like if there was
story so of sad. My life.
If there was ever so a man sad. Down here, we're just
Sarah. Seeing, don't look at me right now.
Yeah, don't stare at him. Don't look away. Don't look at him. Like, avert your gaze. Yeah, whatever's left down here is like there. I think a man may have used to be here.
Yeah,
not anymore.
Somebody that used to love his life.
Go to Facebook, won't you, please? Check us out on Twitter. We're at Couch Pilots. It's pretty easy to find us.
Yeah. And CouchPilotsPodcast.com. It's a one-stop shop. You invented that phrase.
I did invent that phrase. Thank you.
You can listen to every episode. There's only two places you can listen to every episode that we've done. It's on Spotify and CouchPilotsPodcast.com. On CouchPilotsPodcast.com, there's a link to our Facebook, our Instagram, which is blowing up. All the hot links.
Yeah, I feel like I said all that already. That's all right though.
Okay. Well, I was.
What about?
You were saying it with emphasis.
I was in the hangar.
I felt it more.
What about the phone number?
Oh, the dial-in number. That's 910-PILOTS-1. Sarah, that is 910-745-6871. Call us. Leave us a voicemail so you can listen to your awesome voice all across the world.
A couple months ago. Blake, for like years, Blake didn't know what the phone number was. So then he said it was 910-PILOTS-1. He didn't know how it broke down to numbers. So he wrote it on a sticky note.
Yeah.
And he put it on the equipment here. And he's so fucking proud of himself that he can read that every episode. Now.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you. It only took me a couple years to figure that out.
That would be me too.
Yeah.
Go to patreon.com. It's a real website. I didn't make it up. And you can give us money if you go there. And we'd like to have money.
As of January 1st, it's updated.
Oh, have you? You have not done it though yet.
But January
1st. You're not doing
it. No, I will. I will have it updated. I will. I feel bad.
How about this? I bet
no.
I bet you right now. Today. What is today? The 13th of December.
Yes.
I bet you $30. You will not do anything to the Patreon. I bet you $30.
Okay.
You know what? I bet you $30 in Moose Bucks.
All right. Shake on it.
Okay.
That'll almost give you a membership for the next year.
No,
I got a free membership next year.
Oh, never mind.
Because I'm such a good
person. Because he's tricked 10 people into joining, including me. Sarah, do you have anything you want to plug at this time? The show's almost over.
I just, who gets copies of those pictures?
The Moose?
Yeah.
Jeremiah said he keeps one on file.
Okay.
And he said the rest will be distributed as needed. I don't know what that
right,
means.
Right, because if you come in and you don't have your card, how else are they going to identify you?
I guess that's
I get
well,
it.
Yeah.
I get it now.
You're not getting one.
I don't want one.
Well, I don't know why you would ask about it.
I just was wondering what they did with it.
Blake, is there anything you want to say at the end of the show?
Sure. In honor of the BBC, in honor of the UK, in honor of Chris Tuckley, I went through, just like my friend Sarah here, I have a list of a lot of facts about... Queen Elizabeth.
You've been very reliable this season.
Yes.
In those facts.
Thank you, because I wrote them all down in one day.
Right.
At work.
Under your desk.
They're lucky to have you.
Who is?
your work.
Oh, yeah. Believe me, they are.
It's called time theft.
Is that what it's called? Time theft?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, so I have a couple.
Ghost theft, that's right.
Ghost wipe theft?
Mm-hmm.
I have a couple of facts about the Queen that I want to share, and there's a different one every week. Queen Elizabeth was the first British monarch to celebrate her diamond wedding anniversary.
Wow.
So that's, I mean, that tells you how old she was at that time.
That's 50, is that right?
Sure.
So Philip was...
And Philip, you know, we all remember that Philip was a cheating drunk early on in their marriage until he was put in line by, we don't know, but he was put in line.
Okay.
We know that, right?
And he just recently died.
Oh, RIP, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But he died at like 97. The Queen's like 93, 90. Like, it's, yeah. Like they're both very, very old.
His funeral, the boys got back together.
That's right.
And they hadn't been together in a while.
Did you?
They didn't talk to each other, but they were together.
Did you see that? There's a post that the Queen has entered a new phase in her health. Have you heard of that?
Yes.
And that she may not be seen for the next few months.
Mm-hmm.
I think when she comes back, she's going to be like an animatronic, which is better than CGI, if you ask me.
Yeah, they probably took DNA from Princess Diana,
right,
which they killed, mm-hmm, which we were talking about before. Yeah. The British family had, you know, the royal family had killed 100%. Princess Diana. So they're probably using some of her DNA stems.
That makes sense.
Also, Queen Elizabeth has received over 3.5 million items of correspondence over the length of her reign.
Holy cow.
Which is probably more because I don't know how the age of these stats were.
It's like, how do you know the age of the stats? How do you know if chickens dream in color? We don't know.
No, we just got to trust what we read,
but
right?
I see it in color. And Sarah, since you're here, I have one more fact.
Please tell me.
In November of 2019, Prince Andrew steps down from royal duties.
Awesome!
And I know you don't listen to the show, and I understand I'm not offended by it.
No one listens to it.
But I've also...
I listen to it occasionally.
Along with two facts about Queen Elizabeth each week... I have been giving one fact about Prince Andrew, the fucking scumbag.
Okay. It's usually negative.
Yeah. So, I'll refresh. From last episode, in November of 2019, Prince Andrew does a BBC interview, later known as Car Crash Interview. And the interview was he quoted as saying that he was never truly close to Mr. Epstein. And he also said he couldn't recollect... Virginia, I'm not going to name her last name because she's a victim, and that the picture that of the two of them was doctored.
Mm.
Also, just the other day, I noticed I found an article where there's a picture of Mr. Epstein and his lady friend.
You keep calling him Mr. Epstein. I thought you didn't say the name of the person who perpetrated crimes, like the mass shooters. You don't say their names.
No, you don't say the victims' names.
But apparently, you don't say the victims' names.
Yeah, okay. you don't never say the victims' names.
My mistake.
Because they might try to get a job.
Sure.
Later.
Yeah, that would. If someone heard the victim's name on this show, there's no way they'd be employed, right?
We have a few episodes left, maybe about three, and let me just tell you, I have got me some facts, but I'm very, very confident.
Right.
That although I have these facts about Mr. fucking Andrew Prince guy, I think I'm going to have some updated facts before we get to the end of this.
Well, I can't wait.
And the other fact is just that his mother is paying for all his legal troubles.
Wow.
His mom's
What's the relation there?
Prince Andrew knew Mr. Epstein and fucked little kids.
Okay.
Blake is... wildly fixated on this.
Okay.
Sometimes it makes me mad.
So when you were like looking into British pilots,
I was already into this before.
Okay.
His mind was already resting there.
Did you watch the documentary? Is that what got you all riled up?
Which one? The Epstein documentary?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Don't tell about the documentary.
That's the end of the show, everybody.
Ooh, Jesus. Yeah, well said. My God.
Sarah, thank you very much for being on the show. It's always great to see you.
Sarah ended the show. Don't tell about documentaries about that guy. You're gonna fucking rot his mind worse than it is.
I saw it already.
He's only a brain stem at this point. You're gonna rot that out.
I mean, I'm a freaky motherfucker.
But there's so many of those right now.
I've never fucked an underage person, and
I did. But I was 17 at the time, so it's fine.
So it's It's like a wash if you're both underage.
Oh yeah,
it's a wash.
It's a dueling statutories. They cancel each other out.